In this video, we'll cover the differences between doing rotoscopy in Softimage and Maya. In Softimage, rotoscopy involves loading an image into a viewport. This image is associated with a specific view or camera, but it's not an actual object in the scene. In Maya, however, rotoscopy is done with actual objects called image planes. Image planes can be attached to a camera so that they always follow it. Or they can be free from the camera, which is similar to the fixed option for rotoscopy in Softimage. Let's start with free image planes, which are often used as references when you're modeling objects and building your scene. One way to create a free image plane is to choose View Image Plane Import Image or Import Movie in an orthographic view, or click this icon in the title bar. Select an image from the browser, and it's loaded at its original size at the scene origin. If you can't see it, it might be because the image plane is comparatively small to the other objects in the scene, or it's hidden within other objects. Let's delete this plane and show you another way to do this, which is to choose Create Free Image Plane. This creates a plane object at the default size, which is defined in its options box. Then you need to access its attributes to load an image for it. On the Shape tab, click the folder icon beside Image Name and select an image. The plane's size changes to match the size of the image that you load. But you can change its precise width and height here, maintaining the original aspect ratio or not. You can also scale the image plane using the Scale Manipulator. Make sure to drag on the XY plane to scale uniformly. To position the image plane in space, you can rotate or translate it as usual. Or set an offset from the plane's center with the image center values. The image plane is visible in all views by default, but you can make it visible by only a particular camera by choosing it from the display list here. Because image planes are actual objects in Maya, they will render by default, which is unlike rotoscoped images in Softimage. If you don't want image planes to be rendered, such as if you're just using them as reference images as you work, you can hide them in different ways prior to rendering. Including turning off their visibility. You can also create a render layer to contain only what you want to render, and then just make sure that the image planes are not included in this layer. Let's delete this free image plane and move on to image planes that are attached to the camera. Go to a viewport where the perspective camera that you want to use is active. Choose View Image Plane Import Image or Import Movie and select an image from the browser, the same as you did for free image planes earlier. The image plane is automatically created at the camera's near clipping plane and fills up the active camera's view. As you can see in the outliner, the image plane is a child of the camera object itself, not an independent object. We'll just delete that and show you another way to create an image plane attached to a camera. Select the camera you want, open its environment attributes, and click on the Create button next to Image Plane. This creates a blank image plane, so you have to then select an image to use. You can adjust the placement options here to fit the image plane to the camera, such as to be within a resolution gate. You can also set the image plane's offset, rotation, and its depth, which is the number of scene units it is from the camera. The Placement Extras options let you determine how the image itself covers the plane. Note that these placement options you used for free image planes have no effect on the ones that are attached to the camera. With image planes that are attached to the camera, you can use the 2D pan and zoom tool, which is similar to the pixel zoom mode in Softimage. As shown in the video Camera Navigation in Maya, this tool lets you pan or zoom without moving the camera so as to maintain the alignment between the image plane and the objects in the scene. In the next video, we'll cover what's displayed in a viewport and how those elements are displayed.